Hello and welcome back to Blumstein Plays Diablo 3 Rise of the Necromancer. We're joined back in the middle of, right in the middle of the fray. In between the recordings, I have changed up our gear a little bit. We've come back to our one-handed. We're trying out that legendary sword that we found, just to see what it's going to be like. But at this current moment in time, I'm running around like a headless chicken once again, trying to get myself. We have got ourselves about 10,000 damage worth of force. And we're giving our minions our form damage as well to see if that causes any extra. Like, it seems to have increased our damage output a little bit. I'm going to see how it goes. I'm not certain, but I'll be interested to see how well it does for us. I've kept my old weapon just in case I have to change back as well, because that is the beauty of this game. Once again, we are still struggling with these shielded, enchanted, knockback, frozen bastards of doom. That is their official title. They're still crap fighting up there, and there's still that naked man who I really wish I knew why he was here. I don't have to just kill him. With like the little crappy things, we do seem to be doing a lot more damage, so I'm assuming that we are doing more damage. But I didn't even notice my health there. Like, I'll be perfect enough, I can probably gap that. What the? What the hell happened there? Oh, don't get involved. You better get involved, stay out of it. I'm slain by a touch of poison. Yeah. Die. You're on your own. Kill him. Everyone, concentrate on one. Maybe that's the problem. Maybe I'm trying to concentrate on everything all at once. Maybe I should be concentrating on one all at once. Jesus Christ. That knockback is just nuts. Holy shit. What a really weird time to level up. I can deal with that in a minute. 141, jeez, we are getting through these levels. I think that just goes to prove how hard this act is. Like, even at the difficulty, I know increasing slowly the amount you level up, but we are still increasing our levels at a quite substantial rate, considering how... We weren't even level 70 by the time we started this level, we were just about to hit it. We literally have gone through level 70 odd, and then star and all that. But did I have like a combined health? Oh, that makes me feel so much better. Ah, I thought it was all one. All three different fucking ones. Ah, that is so much more put me at ease. Ah, I don't feel, well, I still feel like a noob, and I'm pretty sure people watching this would agree that I am not very good at this game. Although I am seeing on the map a distraction. Hi, random naked guy. How are you? I need to spend some points. I've got 2 points to spend. I feel like I should probably put some more into health. Or movement speed. Or maximum essence. But I'm going to put it into intelligence, because I'm an anarchist. Why do I press accept like that? Power on, there it is. Utility. Area damage. How many points have I got here? 10. So I could have like 10% area damage as well. If I like just changed everything into it. Might have to have a look at the Paragon points. I'm not sure if I'm like min-maxing right. I know obviously it's down to me what I put into it, but at the same time it's like I want it to be a bit more effective than it is. Stand here. Caverns of Luray. Why not? We'll have a look. Level 1. Oh, and if anyone's interested in seeing, there's a new film coming out this year called Ready Player One. I'm actually quite looking forward to that. Like, if anyone would be interested in me doing film reviews as well, it might be something I would be willing to do, because like, I quite like talking about films, love movies, there's a lot of them coming out this year. There's some really good films coming out this year. I haven't seen it yet, but Black Panther's supposedly going to be really good. We've got Infinity Wars, we've got ready for the one. I think there's a couple more leagues coming out this year. Yes, a good few leagues coming out. And I'll be one of them, so I'm talking about that. Yeah, I'm thinking that we are doing a lot more damage on this. Yeah, we actually feel like we're getting through things fairly okay. What's that? A weird, different kind of monster. No! Oh, there's nothing over there. See, this is why we don't have food. Because I get distracted by caverns and caves. All the pretty things. We're definitely doing more damage with this. Especially with the fawns as well. I feel like the fawns are really helpful. Wow, we leveled up really quickly. Holy crap. Ammo. Give it up. I think the fawns go to my other minions as well, like, not to like my revives. Be pretty cool if they do. It's a lot of experience. Offense. More attack speed. More attacks the better. We're definitely doing a lot more damage. Here we've got that like more quick More quick succession damage than we do just standard big blasting hits. Although I must confess, I've never played the Barbarian class in Diablo. Sorry, I have no idea how good or crap it is. No! Speaking of Barbarian classes as well, I'm actually currently in the middle of creating a custom campaign for a few of my friends to play Dungeons and Dragons, so if you've got any ideas that you feel like sharing, please feel free to leave them in the comments, and I'll be more than happy to listen and like, give my feedback and maybe even include it in what I'm doing. So currently at the moment, I'm planning a bit of an undead campaign. I don't think they know that, so if they're watching this, they'll find out, which I don't know if they will be or not, so if you're watching this, hey, you've got a bit of an insight, if you've done the research. If not, it's going to be a bit of a surprise. There's a few ideas I'm batting around. I have my wonderful girlfriend, who's helping me out with it as well. She's very... ow. She's not very ow, she's very great to me. I'm very, very lucky to have her. Hey, jeez, let me respawn! Let me come back! Need maggots, need help. God, these things are horrible. God, it's like poison and fire and shit everywhere. Caper, molten poison, enchanted, electrified, reflects damage. Sorry, what? Jeez. Just keep healing. Just keep healing. Look at that. Jeez. Oh, and explosion. Wonderful. Like these bloody like enemies of this kind of like when you reach this level are nuts. They got like 1, 2, 3, 4 I was reading. Like 5 or 6 different like magical enchantments on them. It's just crazy. Him. That's not much, but take his armor. It's the last one, so theoretically he's the one that should have the loot. Get him! I can tell he's the one with the loot, because he's the one with the death breath. I don't know if I need death breath for anything, though. I think I've used what I need of that. Oh wait, maggots. Definitely doing more damage. 100%. It says the thing does a bit more damage, but I think we're doing more damage per second, so... Flashing Creeper. Oh, I haven't seen any of them in ages. I think the last time I saw them was Act 3. Shit! What was that? Something just done a hell of a ton of damage. Come, my maggot friends, come! Like the maggot army. Hey, keep it going. Aggro more. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Keep things aggro. You can, God, I dread to think what speedrun for this game is, considering how much time I spent with it. But I must be one of the slowest runs humanly possible for this game. And then, keep everything up, get me the bonus XP. Maybe I should leave him to that and then try and like, aggro some more. Is there anything else? I can do it in time. He really has to go quickly. Maggot army! It's a crappy little maggot. I need to do the maggot, which is quite good because these are quite good for XP. Good little grindy spots. What level does your paragon end? Is it continuous or does it end at like level 70 on the paragon as well? Dying. I feel like it'll keep going for a little bit longer than the actual regular levels because you don't get as much of a gain out of them. He says. Probably not knowing what he's talking about. There! Yeah, I think I've acted that. Jeez! Oh, those Lash on Creeper things, they hurt. Join me. I'm seeing a lot of bigger numbers popping up, especially for my minions. I think that form damage really helps the minions out. Makes them a bit more useful, especially when there's so many of them. Accidentally look at their banner for some reason. There you go, you can enjoy that a little bit. Kill the maggot beast. What happened again? Did I die again? Half times experience at this kind of level is bloody helpful. I like the fact there's loads of easy to kill bloody crappy maggots. I dread to think what this would be like if I was playing one of those classes where the same class. You can play a necromancer, as a kind of solo necromancer with no summons and all that, and it actually, like, there's certain things you can give yourself to make you do more damage than that, but I hate to think what it'd be like to not actually have my summons and minions with me, because I've got so used to it, I just dread to think of life without them. I've grown accustomed to them. They're part of the family. Come, minions! If I'm not constantly using that, I tell you what, Siphon Blood is the best. Normal attack. Gets you the most amount of essence. I don't know if it does the most amount of damage. It probably doesn't do the greatest damage in comparison to the other. Actually, I don't know. I don't know if the damage is based off it. It's just based off your stats and your weapons. So, I don't know if it's actually based off the attack itself. It makes me wonder if there is. This, I don't see why you wouldn't use Siphon Blood, because it heals you, does the most amount of essence regain. I don't know what the payoff is for it. I don't know what the bad side to using this is. Stairs. I feel like stairs are important. I feel like this could be leading me to level 2. That led me to another chest. There's a lot of chests in there. Yeah, I'm not complaining. I'm happy with chests. Kill the... Oh, don't kill the chests. Bastards over there, they do loads of damage. This place is great! Not so much great for loot, but great for experience. The size of that spear. Restless disemboweler of death. I've just about picked myself alive. Holy crap. I want to pick up a restless disemboweler of death. That sounds amazing. It's going to be crap, it's blue. The name of it sounds so amazingly awesome. There is so much going on in the game, I can't even believe. But that's saying something. You very rarely get stuck in this level. Ow! What happened there? I'll take it. Go, my minion! I got minions. Kill him! Stun. Oh, the stun. The freezing stun lock is just amazing. Can I have something? I haven't even found anything yellow. I can hear there's something nasty. Life regeneration, we get a bit more of that. Take out that maggot brood again. There's a lot of maggot broods here. I love it. This is great for XP. I'm just grinding away like mad at that. Die. You bitch, die! Ooh, the siphon. This is a yellow. But I'm kind of, I'm kind of happy to have the doors actually. I'm kind of rage that I don't have any bloody arcane dust. I can get loads of arcane dust now. Oh, everyone has different restrictions. So I say they're stacked, don't they? If I remember rightly, they're pretty good actually, the Nephilim Spirit things. Where am I going? Go down here and to the right, I guess. And have a quick once over before I go, and then decide whether to leave this cave or not, because I do want to continue with the main story. There's so many cooler things I can do later on as well. Crap. Holy nuts. He's lashing people's heart like fuck. Maggots are just great experience, right? Anyway, if you find a cave like this, great places to grind. Because this doesn't feel too much of a challenge. Yeah, I know I've died a couple of times, but that's more because I've just not been paying attention to be perfectly honest. No shortages of anything. Enemies everywhere. Corpses everywhere once you kill those enemies. Just want to check something. Whoa! Okay, we have got a lot of loot. That's crap. That's what I've got. It's actually better than the other one, I swear. Yeah, it is! The hell? Where's the blue one better? Two hanging? The hell's going on with my voice? Disemboweler of death. Sounds amazing, but it's crap. Just have a look at some of the shit we got. I could always... Oh. 15... Okay, so shield sent to give me more essence. I did not know that. I'm wondering if maybe there's a... Oh, there's a poor man. Sorry, bub. Chill your beans! Oh, that. It's the quickest I've seen anything's health go down the entire time I've played their Nightmarish mode. Sorry, Torment. Which we started on Nightmarish. Nightmarish, see, I can see what people are saying. I know when people are saying, oh, Nightmarish just stays up. So, you know, it's like the second hardest. I was wrong. And I realise Nightmarish is a piece of piss now. I feel like this is making me a better Diablo player, kind of.
but not that much.
Okay. Oh, I could go all the way back up there, but that's effort. So, I think we're going to leave this here. Like, it probably does have some good stuff in here somewhere, but we might come back. But anyway, I've been Tim Palmstein. Thank you very much for watching. If you like what you've seen, please remember to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.